Good morning everyone. Now I would like to discuss some problems on test of the convergence. First we can observe which test is suitable on that given series. Okay, I am taking some four problems here. Test of the convergence of the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity n square by 2 power n. Second one, sigma 3n minus 1 by 2 power n. Third one is sigma x power 2n by n plus 2 under root of n plus 2, greater x is greater than 0. Fourth one, sigma root 5 minus 1 whole power n by n square plus 1. Here we can apply D'Alembert's ratio test clearly. Why? Because the comparison test means in the denominator factors more than the numerator factors, then we can compare with the other series. If that series is also depends on the P test, is it convergent or divergent? But you observe here, if x term is any there, any term is expressing that un series in x variable, then simply we can check the D'Alembert's ratio test. Now one more thing here, n square and 2 power n, only single terms are there. Here also 3n minus 1 by 2 power n. Here also whole power n by n square plus 1. Here we can apply Cauchy's nth root test also. Why? Because if the expression is in power form n, then we can go for the Cauchy's nth root test. But it is also solved by the D'Alembert's ratio test also. Okay, here the given series, let it be the first one, sigma un is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity n square by 2 power n. Here clearly un is equal to n square by 2 power n. Why we can choose the D'Alembert's ratio test means in the D'Alembert's ratio we can take un and un plus 1. If the same terms can be expressed but only the difference is n is replaced by n plus 1. If in the denominator 2 power n is there, in the next 2 power n plus 1, the 2 power n get cancelled in the simplification when we take the ratios. Okay, here also n square, there n plus 1 whole square. We can take n is common, then n square term is eliminated. We are getting the n value that is either greater than or less than or equal to 0 by the simplification of ratio un and un plus 1 and applying the limits. Okay, here un plus 1 is equal to n plus 1 whole square by 2 power n plus 1. Taking the ratio un by un plus 1, that is equal to n square by 2 power n by n plus 1 whole square by 2 power n plus 1. The n terms are equal, so we can choose the D'Alembert's ratio test, that is n square by 2 power n into 2 power n plus 1 by n plus 1 whole square. In the numerator n square, 2 power n can be written as 2 power n into 2 by 2 power n. In the denominator, taking common n, then n square is common, 1 plus 1 by n whole square. N power n, 2 power n, 2 power n get cancelled. N square get cancelled. It is equal to 2 by 1 plus 1 by n whole square. Now we take the limits. Limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1, that is equal to limit n tends to infinity 2 by 1 plus 1 by n whole square. Applying the limits 2 by 1 plus 1 by infinity, that is 1 by infinity is 0, it is 2, this is equal to l greater than 1. By D'Alembert's ratio test, D'Alembert's ratio test, limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 is equal to L. The conditions are, the first one is, if L is greater than 1, then sigma un is convergent. If second one is, if L is less than 1, then sigma un is divergent. Third one is, if L equal to 1, the test fails to decide, the test fails to decide the nature of the convergence. Okay, here clearly L is greater than 1 by the D'Alembert's ratio test. Therefore, sigma un equal to sigma n squared by 2 power n is convergent series. It is the convergent. Okay. Next, I am solving the second problem. Second solution, sigma un is equal to sigma 3n minus 1 by 2 power n. Here un equal to 3 power n minus 1 by 2 power n. It is a positive term series. Okay, un equal to 3n minus 1 by 2 power n. Un plus 1 equal to 3 of n plus 1 minus 1 by 2 power n. This is equal to 3n plus 2 by 2 power n plus 3 minus 1 plus 2. Next we can take the ratio un by un plus 1 is equal to un is 3n minus 1 by n power n by 3n plus 2 by 2 power here in the place of n plus 1. It is equal to 3n minus 1 by 2 power n into 2 power n plus 1 by 3n plus 2. This is equal to 3n minus 1. In this, taking common n, 3 minus 1 by n into 2 power n plus 1 can be written as 2 power n into 2 power 1 by 2 power n. Here also taking common n, 3 plus 2 by n. This 2 power n cancel, n cancel. Why? Because we can take the limits. Limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1. That is equal to here write 2 into 3 minus 1 by n by 3 plus 2 by n. That is un by un plus 1. Here apply the limits n tends to infinity. 2 into 3 minus 1 by n by 3 plus 2 by n. We know that as n tends to infinity, 1 by n is tends to 0. Here this is 0, it is 0. This is equal to 2 into 3 by 3. 3 get cancelled. This is 2. It is clearly greater than 1. So, by D'Alembert's ratio test, if limit n tends to infinity, un by un plus 1 equal to L. If L is greater than 1, then sigma un is convergent. If L is less than 1, then sigma un is divergent. If L equal to 1, the test fails. Here sigma un equal to sigma 3n minus 1 by 2 power n is convergent series. Okay. Next, third one. third solution. Sigma un equal to sigma x power 2n by n plus 2 into under root of n plus 2. Here, if x is greater than 0, it is clearly the positive term series. Okay, here un equal to x power 2n by n plus 2 into under root of n plus 2. Un plus 1 is equal to x power 2 into n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus 2 under root of n plus 1 plus 2. Then un by un plus 1 is equal to x power 2n by n plus 2 under root n plus 2 whole by x power 2n plus 2 by n plus 3 under root of n plus 3. This is equal to x power 2n by n plus 2 into under root of n plus 2 into n plus 3 under root of n plus 3 by x power 2n plus 2. Here, taking common n in the under root and this factor, n in the under root and this factor, this can be written as x power 2n into x square is equal to x power 2n into n common 1 plus 3 by n root n common under root of 1 plus 3 by n by n common 1 plus 2 by n under root n common under root of 1 plus 2 by n x power 2n into x square. This root n, n, x power 2n, x power 2n get cancelled. Next, un by un plus 1 is equal to 1 plus 3 by n into under root of 1 plus 3 by n by 1 plus 2 by n into under root of 1 plus 2 by n into 1 by x square. Applying the limit n tends to infinity, un by un plus 1 equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 3 by n into under root of 1 plus 3 by n by 1 plus 2 by n under root of 1 plus 2 by n into 1 by x square. If applying the limits, then 3 by n is 0 and 3 by n is 0, 3, 2 by n is 0, 2 by n is there. 1 into root 1, this is 1. 1 into root 1 is also 1. Why? Because 1 plus 0 is 1. Under root of 1 plus 0 is root 1. Numerator is also. This is simply, it is equal to 1 by x square. Here, L is equal to 1 by x square. By using D'Alembert's ratio test, limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 equal to L. Then if L is greater than 1, sigma un is convergent. If L is less than 1, sigma un is divergent. If L equal to 1, the test fails to decide. The same way, L equal to 1 by x square is greater than 1, that implies 1 is greater than x square, then sigma un is convergent. This convergent. This is the first case. Second one, if 1 by x square is less than 1, that implies 1 is less than x square, sigma un is divergent. Third case, if 1 by x square equal to 1, that implies x square equal to 1, the test fails to decide the nature. Okay, this is the, if the expression is in x, then we cannot say that in x is equal to 1 case, then we cannot say that is it divergent or convergent, and the other relations are depends on the L values only. Okay, next, fourth one. Sigma un equal to sigma root 5 minus 1 whole power n by n square plus 1. Here un equal to root 5 minus 1 by n square plus 1. Whole power n. We know that root 4 is equal to 2, 2 minus 1. It is root 5 means 2 point something, it's clearly positive term. So un is positive terms of series. Okay, now we can take un plus 1. It's root 5 minus 1 whole power n plus 1. By n plus 1 whole square plus 1. This is equal to root 5 minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by a plus b whole square n square plus 2n plus 1 plus 1. This is equal to root 5 minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n square plus 2n plus 2. Taking the ratio un by un plus 1 is equal to root 5 minus 1 whole power n divides n square plus 1 whole by root 5 minus 1 whole power n plus 1 divides n square plus 2n plus 2. It can be written as root 5 minus 1 whole power n by n square plus 1 into n square plus 2n plus 2 by root 5 minus 1 whole power n plus 1. This is taking to the numerator, or that is we can write separately root 5 minus 1 whole power n. In this, taking common n square 1 plus 2 by n plus 2 by n square by n square common 1 plus 1 by n square. Here root 5 minus 1 whole power n into root 5 minus 1. This get cancelled, n square cancel. Here un by un plus 1 is equal to 1 plus 2 by n plus 2 by n square by 1 plus 1 by n square into root 5 minus 1. Applying the limits, limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 is equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 2 by n plus 2 by n square by 1 plus 1 by n square into root 5 minus 1. Then this is equal to 1 plus 0 by 1 plus 0 into root 5 minus 1. This is equal to 1 by root 5 means this is 2 point something, 2.2 minus 1, that is 1.13 something. It's 100 by, suppose 113, it's clearly less than 1. It is clearly less than 1. So here we can write 1 by root 5 minus 1, it is clearly less than 1. Why? Because root 5 minus 1 is greater than of 1 point something. So here 1 denominator is more than of 1, so it's clearly less than 1. By D'Alembert's ratio test, limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 equal to L. If L is greater than 1, sigma un is convergent. If L is less than 1, divergent L equal to 1 test fits. Here clearly the L value is less than 1. So therefore sigma un equal to sigma root 5 minus 1 whole power n by L square plus 1 is divergent series. Is divergent series. Okay. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share to your friends. Thank you.